Welcome to EYEFACTIVE. I'm Johannes, and today I will show you about the interactive capabilities of our software platform running on large format touchscreens. I'll start here on our touch table and introduce some basic wordings first. So obviously we are here on a multi-touch table, so this is what we call multi-touch interaction. On the other hand, a table like this invites multiple users, multiple people, to interact at the same time. So I can open up as many windows I will like, and this could be multiple users opening their own apps and having their own part of the table where they interact. So this is multi-user interaction and deeply integrated into our software platform and SDK. So what kind of elements do we have here that we can work with? Let's start with the widgets. So this can be simple widgets like an image or a PDF widget where I can zoom in. We can, of course, load video files. We can even load 3D models like this cube. This could be a 3D rendering of a product, for example. And we can dive into a little bit more complex widgets like this slider, where we have multiple contents all in one window, or this heap widget. We will come to that later. And our well-known four slice widget, which has a flexible structure, so we can navigate this. And yeah, of course, we can define all the type of contents that we want to integrate here ourselves. So these are the widgets, the smallest user interface elements that you can integrate within our app suite. As we are running our own app store, we of course also have our own apps. So here's an overview of a few of them. Let's start with Hotspot as one example. So this is what Hotspot actually looks like when you download it from our app store. You see it's a very colorful world map. I can zoom into Europe, for example. All that hotspots expand. They have been grouped before, and I can navigate to other areas of the world how I like. But obviously, this style of the world map, this colorful style, is nothing that one of our clients would like to have when they present their own company, their own branches worldwide, or even just in a smaller region like a country or a city. So the capability of this app, and this counts for all of our apps, is that they can easily be customized. I will show you now another example. I will open up the Hotspots app again, but this time in a fully customized version. So as you see now, the look and feel totally changed. It's not even a real map anymore. It's basically an indoor map, you could say. And yeah, and now we have some contents here, so we can open the hotspots, and now we find one of those four slice widgets that we've seen earlier. All of this customization can be done without a single line of coding. So it's a no-code platform. You simply use our CMS functionalities to create this customized version of hotspots yourself. We have around 30 apps in our App Store public available. You can download them, you can customize them and run them, but you can also combine them and create projects that consist of multiple apps. So I'm going to show you now one example of a project that consists of multiple apps. This is a project we did for QNB, a large bank in the Middle East area. They are located in Qatar. And as I'm browsing through this menu, I have different topics that I can load. This one is the timeline, for example. So if I navigate into it, we see that we have a timeline of the last years and some contents that we can open and take a closer look to. If I go back and back again, and open the financials tab here, the user interface is different from the timeline. So it's all branded in the CI of QNB, but the contents and the user interface structure changes depending on the topic that we are loading. We could also go into history here and once again have another type of user interface that we can browse. So this one is very playful. And of course, it's also multi-user enabled again, so multiple users can interact with the single images as they like. Last but not least, let's have a look into this global network tab here. So this one is loading a little bit longer as we have a complex 3D globe, which you see now. And I can navigate the globe to explore all the branches Q&B has around the world. So we could look into UAE, for example, and see that they are in the Middle East area. We see the branch they have in UAE with some details about it. All of this project details, all of the different user interfaces have been created just based on the standard apps we have in our app store. So no specific coding was made to create this project, and this explains or shows the capabilities of the app platform. One more thing worth to mention is our object recognition. This works particularly well on touch tablets like this one. I will load a content or a project which is meant to explore smartphones and smartphone plans and other products. I have either the option to just browse smartphones through touch gestures like this one. This one again is multi-user enabled, so multiple users can load different contents as they like. But there's also the possibility to just take a smartphone dummy, which I have here, place it on the screen, and start the customer journey like this. So now I can just rotate this smartphone to go through the features and see some images of different color variations, etc. I can also place another phone. This one will also be detected, and now I have an iPhone here with all the details it offers. All of these widgets and apps and contents and projects are managed through our CMS functionalities. We call it the App Manager. To access the App Manager, I have to have a keyboard. So not every user standing on a table can simply access and maybe change some settings. So I will hit M to access the App Manager now. This is first leading me to this dashboard where I see some version information and if there are updates available and how many apps there are, etc. So the first step I will do is I will look into the apps section, which I loaded now. And as you can see, there is a long list of available apps. These are either already installed on this device, on this table, or available from our app store. So all the apps which have a green icon, like the one here in the middle, are public available, so you can download them as well. If we look into live photo here, we see that there is a green version number showing up. If I go deeper here, then I see that there is an install update button up here, so I can simply install the available apps update like I'm used to it to do it on my smartphone or tablet. So we bring all the convenience you have from smartphone and tablets and the app stores available on them onto large touch table devices, as well as totems and kiosk. The next thing I will do is go into projects. So there are many projects installed. That's why it takes some time to load. And again, we see that there is a long, long list of projects. Many of them are just available in the cloud and connected to my account here. So that's why I see so many download buttons here. Others are already installed on this device. Let's find a good example project like this one here, Porsche maybe, to see how a project is created or how a project is built up, right? On the right-hand side, we have a list with all the apps and widgets which are used in this particular project. So you see there are widgets, there's a media browser, cards view, slideshow FX, web browser, etc. If we go into the web browser, for example, we can customize it. So we could, for example, change styling colors for buttons, for address bars, etc., according to our own corporate identity. And we can configure the web browser. So one main thing to do would be to enter the website that it should load when it's started up. But if I open all of these ribbons here, you will see there is just a bunch of options that you can configure with this web browser. So for example, should it behave like a desktop web browser or a mobile web browser? Are there any websites whitelisted or blacklisted? Can I zoom in? Can I print? Can I put in my own website that I want to load, or is it fixed to the one which is pre-configured? And tons of more options. This type of configuration is available for each and every app and widget. And it's depending on the capabilities and features that the apps are offering. So if we go into this widget as another example, we have this editor tab here, and we see this widget is configured as a slider, and the contents that should be displayed in this widget are loaded from this content folder. So it's very simple to set up a widget which is a slider and load the contents into it. And if we want to do more detailed configurations, for example, here in the video section, we can activate autoplay if we like to, or loop so that the video will play automatically once I load it and loop again when it's finished. I can simply save those settings I made, go back to the project section here. That was my Porsche project up here. And if I finished all the editing or project creating and editing I wanted to do, I'm able to upload this project to my personalized cloud, which is part of our app store and app platform. And once I uploaded this project to the cloud, I will be able, on the other hand, to deploy it to one or multiple touchscreens which are connected to my account as well. So this makes it very easy to set up and to maintain contents and to push them to as many devices as you like, if you have multiple devices installed in your branches, for example. Our app platform can be used on all types of touchscreens. This includes, of course, touch tables, but also tablets for the point of sale or kiosk systems like this one or that one, totems like this one, wall-mounted touchscreens and meeting rooms, for example, and even video walls, LCD video walls and LED video walls that can be upgraded. The multi-user capabilities I've shown you on the touch table are very useful for touch video walls as well, as the large format invites multiple users to interact at the same time. It's always the same platform running on each and every device. So as you can see here, we have here the same widgets and apps and pucks that we have earlier seen on the touch table. So we can really install each and every content on all devices. This is the same widgets here. What you need to consider is to configure your project to run in the right aspect ratio, may it be landscape or portrait like this one, and of course resolution. And every device allows us to walk into the app manager, browse new apps, and install them as we have seen it earlier. All of this runs under Windows, and you can install it on your desktop PC or laptop and do all the configurations you see here sitting on your desk, and then upload it to the cloud and deploy it to the devices that you like. Also, kiosk systems are supported, like this one or this one, including the support for receipt printers, cash terminals, all kinds of scanners like QR code scanners, barcode scanners, RFID scanners, so that you can scan products. And you see here, this application is designed for kiosk browsing, and you have multi-touch interactions as well, and find your right products and order them if you like. If you want to try out the software, just visit our app store, create an account and download the apps you like, and then you are ready to go. Hope to see you soon. Bye.